Cảm ơn quý vị đã chờ đợi. Sau đây là cuộc phỏng vấn phần 2 giữa Bích Phượng và ông thượng nghị sĩ Jim Webb. Thượng nghị sĩ Webb, please share with us the program, the time, the events, and who to contact.
Okay, we are going to issue a statement through the Lost Soldier Foundation. It will be on social media about the exact program, probably by the end of this week. But what we do know right now is that the ceremony will start at 9 in the morning on the 26th of October, and we will have a number of speakers. Mayor Tha is going to come. Our Secretary of the Navy is going to be there.
Phan Nhật Nam.
Phan Nhật Nam is going to be there. Fred Smith, the founder of FedEx, who served with great distinction in Vietnam and really helped us in financing, is going to be there. And this will be a ceremony at Freedom Park in Westminster. And then we will proceed to a second ceremony at the cemetery, which is about a mile away from there, for a military-style funeral service and then the interment of the remains. You don't need a ticket to come, but, you know, it's, you know, I think a lot of people are going to come. So if people... I hope people will come and, you know. And if people have requests for information, they can contact us at Lost Soldiers Foundation. There's contact information on that, and we will be sending out notices too.
Is there the Facebook for the Lost Soldier Foundation?
No, there's not. We've just put this together pretty quickly. But Jeff, we could probably get you a superscript or something to put on for our council and treasurer, who is the person to contact. His name is Jeff McFadden.
Talking about the remaining and will be in Westminster, California. Can we go back a little bit more? I know you're involved with Vietnamese cemetery in Vietnam called Binh Hoa, Nghĩa Trang Quân đội Binh Hoa.
Yes, yes. When I first went back to Vietnam in 1991, one of the things that struck me was that the cemeteries for the Vietnam Cộng Hòa people basically were allowed to grow over with vegetation and to be ignored. And actually, in the Binh Hoa cemetery, I think over the gate it said Nguy.
Nguy.
Yes. So, you know, I started writing about this in the early 1990s, that if we want to move forward in our relations with Vietnam, we have to show mutual respect. When I first was going back to Vietnam in the early 90s, I would shake hands with our former enemy, and they would say, Lam Hoa Binh, and I would say, yes, I will shake your hand if you will shake the hand of the Vietnam Cộng Hòa. Let's all move forward. We're all in the same battlefield. So I worked on these cemetery issues for many years when I was in the Senate. I visited the Binh Hoa Cemetery a couple of times. We were able to walk through and see the conditions of it. And we worked hard to try to get the cemetery. We even talked about the idea of letting overseas Vietnamese fund major renovations in the cemetery. And then they decided to turn the cemetery into local control.
Yes.
And there was a road that went through the middle of it the last time I visited it. It's a very important issue, I think, in terms of eventually resolving the wages of the war.
So if you go back again, can you please check if they still have the word Nguy on it?
No, that was a long time ago.
Oh,
that was
a long
off.
Time
that
ago.
Was off
That's
by
off
the
now?
Time I was in the Senate, but that had been up there, after the war.
So right. Do you know any hope on that Nghĩa Trang Binh Hoa?
I'd have to learn more about what they are allowing now. It's a slow step-by-step process, but I believe if I were the Hanoi government, I would believe that this would be a smart thing for them to do, because the number one issue, I think, in terms of moving forward is having good repaired relations with the Vietnamese community, the overseas Vietnamese community. And it would go a long way if they would make that gesture.
I believe that a lot of us here have, do a lot of fundraiser and send the money back home and rebuild those cemetery, Nghĩa Trang Quân đội Binh Hoa. Myself, have contributed with a lot of money, people that donated because of taking picture with my Vietnam Cộng Hòa Mustang. Mm-hmm. So I hope maybe one day with your assistant and everyone really sit down and move on, talk about, you know, forget the past and just concentrate, redo our cemetery in Binh Hoa.
Well, cemeteries and all other issues regarding the people who fought during the war.
Yes.
I mean, that's what I, my word inside Vietnam has always been mutual respect. Whether it's trying to find those who've been missing or how you allow the former Vietnam Cộng Hòa soldiers to participate fully in society. And there have been changes over the years in a lot of those areas, but that's, you know, we should continue to work on that.
Senator Webb, my last question, the foundation called the Lost Soldiers or?
Lost Soldiers maybe, Foundation.
Yeah, the yes. Lost Soldier Foundation.
We created this foundation after I got full authority to be the legal custodian when we knew we were going to be able to do this. And we asked mostly American Vietnam veterans. I sent a small list out and I told them the story and that we needed money in order to buy burial plots, conduct a ceremony, get our people over there to travel, just the basic mechanics of it. And we got a really good response, although this event I think is becoming much larger than we thought it was going to be. But we, you know, we've done well with our foundation, and it was designed specifically to deal with this particular ceremony.
So your message to all the Vietnamese people in California will be attending, or people will be from different state, different country, flying over for this special ceremony. And I would like to say our deepest gratitude for what you have done.
Well, thank you. And I think this will be a special day. And I hope we will get a lot of people and American veterans and American family members, too, to come out for that.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Thank
and
you.
Thank you for the special interview with SPDN and VATV.
Nice to be with you. Thank you.
Thông báo, kính mời quý đồng hương, quý cựu quân cán chính Việt Nam Cộng Hòa và quý anh chị em thanh niên nam nữ đến tham dự đêm tri ân thế hệ cha anh Việt Nam Cộng Hòa và đồng minh Hoa Kỳ lúc 5 giờ chiều ngày Chủ nhật ngày 3 tháng 11 năm 2019. The Orchid Banquet Hall, 521 Old Little Road, Charlotte, North Carolina, 28214. Có sự hiện diện cựu chuẩn tướng biệt động quân Phạm Duy Tất, Đại tá Hải quân Hoa Kỳ Nguyễn Trọng, đặc biệt có mặt khoa học gia Dương Nguyệt Ánh, chương trình văn nghệ do nữ ca nhạc sĩ Nguyệt Ánh và ca sĩ Huỳnh Phi Tiễn phụ trách. Mọi liên lạc xin gọi Hoàng Tịnh 803-389-8002, Tạ Ngọc Trân 704-241-0117, Cô Lê Phạm 704-264-7143. Hậu duệ Việt Nam Cộng Hòa Hải Ngoại tổ chức trân trọng kính mời.
Việt Tộc Foundation kính mời quý vị tham dự dạ tiệc gây quỹ, giúp anh chị em sắc tộc tại các vùng cao nguyên Việt Nam, tại nhà hàng Harvest Moon 7260 Arlington Boulevard, Fauchard, Virginia, ngày thứ Bảy 26 tháng 10 năm 2019, vào lúc 6:30, với sự góp mặt của các ca sĩ từ California, Sheila, Hoàng Tú và Phương Dung. Để giữ vé xin liên lạc Ung Kim Lâm 703-307-5001, Trần Thanh Tùng 571-344-4100, Nguyễn Hữu Anh 202-375-9221, Đặng Nguyên Đức 301-437-5420 và Sài Gòn USA 703-373-9277.